The density of a substance is defined as the mass of the substance per unit volume of the substance. And this is given in units such as grams per centimeter cubed, kilograms per meter cubed, or pound mass per feet cubed. And we use the Greek symbol rho to designate density. So density is often used as a conversion factor relating mass to volume. For example, if you're given the volume of a substance, we can use the density of it to come up with the mass. So if rho is equal to the mass times the volume, then the mass is going to be equal to the density, or rho, times the volume. And you can do it the same way. If you know the mass and the density, you can find the volume. So another property of a substance is its specific volume, and it usually is indicated by this. Since specific refers to per unit mass, sometimes per unit mole, but here we're going to look at it per unit mass, the specific volume is going to be equal to the total volume divided by its mass. And here the units are going to be things like this volume centimeter cubed divided by g, or grams. And as you can see, this specific volume is equal to the inverse of the density. Where do we see this? Specific volume is often used in thermodynamics, where, for example, steam tables use specific volume as a property. So where do you find density values? Well, you can use a standard reference book, or you can go online and type in what substance you're looking for the density of. However, many tables provide what's known as the specific gravity of a substance. So that's abbreviated capital S, capital G. And the specific gravity of a substance is equal to the density of whatever the substance is divided by the reference density. So the most common reference densities we have, so for solids and liquids, what we use is water at 4 degrees C. And so therefore, our reference density is going to be equal to 1.00 grams per centimeter cubed, or 1,000 kilograms per meter cubed, or in English or American units, 62.43 pound mass per feet cubed. And as you can see by this, hopefully, that the specific gravity is unitless. Note in particular this reference density, because many students think the reference density should be 1 kilogram per meter cubed rather than 1,000 kilograms per meter cubed. If you want, you can do the conversion to prove to yourself that it actually is 1,000. Those are the reference densities for liquids and solids. For gases, it's generally dry air at 20 degrees C, which is equal to 1.2 03 kilograms per meter cubed. In order to find the density of a substance, you multiply the tabulated specific gravity times whatever your reference density is. For example, let's look at the specific gravity of mercury, and at 4 degrees C, it's equal to 13.6. And remember, that is unitless. So if we want to find the density of mercury in grams per centimeter cubed at 4 degrees C, we just multiply 13.6 times the reference density. And again, I'm using this one because we want it in grams per centimeter cubed. And we find that the density is 13.6 grams per centimeter cubed. One thing to be careful of is that density is a function of temperature. Therefore, it is important to use the correct specific gravity for your particular temperature.